All right, so welcome back. Now, briefly, if you want to do a few operations in AutoCAD, like I said, constraining movements of your cursor so that it's orthogonal, you restrict cursor mode orthogonally, you click on your auto. The shortcut key is F8. So once you click on your auto, you can draw a line that is straight, okay? And you can draw it as straight as you want. And when you're done, you simply hit the enter key, or you press escape, or you right click and you hit the enter key. Okay, now the second thing I want to show you, that you can also restrict these lines at specified angles. So if you turn off the auto mode, if you want to use the restriction specified angles, you can't use both of them at the same time, so you turn on one. So in the restrict angles, you find 90 180, you find 45 90 30 60. So this will be useful when we start doing things like auxiliary projections, isometric, and all that. So if you turn on to say 45, let's say 30 60, so you draw a line. Okay, so what it does is that it locks in at that angle. So if I draw a line that is straight, and then I want to draw a line, so you notice that you notice the green line that has popped up. So what it's simply doing is that it locks in at 60 degrees, and then you can actually enter your length that you want to draw, and then you hit the enter key, and then you know that it is is correct. Okay, so you can also do the same thing at 30 degrees. You draw another line from this point, you see it locks in at that angle. So when you see the green line popping up, it just locks in at that angle. Okay, so you can notice that it kind of wants to, you know, snap in at that point. So it's not as restrictive as your auto, but it does a good job. The next thing you want to see is that you want to see your polar snapping, object snap. Your object snap snaps your object to different modes. So this is a typical example. If I want to say, let's control A, delete what's on the screen. So if I draw a line, and I want to draw another line from the midpoint. No, naturally, if I was using my T-square, my drawing board, what I would do is that I will, find a way to measure the middle of this line and then do all those things. But it's easier when you're using AutoCAD. So I make sure that all snap is on. The object snap is on. The object snap, the shortcut key is function F3 for your object snap. You can see function F3, and then you have other snap options. You can snap to the end point, to the midpoint, to the center. So you don't have to select all the options, just select a few of them. Some by default, this would have been selected by default. I just want to make sure that the midpoint and end point is selected. So what I will do is I will show you how this works. So if I want to pick a line from the middle, so you notice that when it gets to the middle, it turns to a rectangle and it shows you that it's midpoint. So I pick this and I draw. Okay, so make sure that auto is on to restrict movements. So I can also draw from the end points. Okay, you see the way it works, and then I also draw from the end points, and that is good. So you can right click, you can pan. The pan is like gives you this hand option to move your screen, and you can also zoom, okay, in and out on the screen. So you pan it. Okay, and then that's okay. So now let's use a circle to describe this. If I draw a circle and I want to draw another circle from the center of the first circle I have drawn, so if you checked your object snap options, you see center, that's center, represent circles, you have intersection, you have nearest. So if I select another circle and then I try to draw from the midpoint, so you see, just hover around it, the midpoint will pop up, and then you select it. And then you draw your circle as you want it done. Okay, so that's actually a good way to proceed with using the midpoint. Now, all this is I've been doing, all the commands I've been doing. Now, if you notice, I've been clicking on the tools from my tools bar and all that. You can also do the same thing from the command line. See, for example, I want to draw. So L will give me a number of all the, it's will give me options, okay? It will give me options of all the lines that I want to draw. You can see L all the commands, different commands that start with L. You see line, you see loft, you see line type, you see layer type. So I just click, or just type the full word line, click enter, and then you see you can actually draw your line. Interestingly, okay, so you can type, say, circle. So when you type the C, it pops up other options, and then okay, ask for the midpoint and for the diameter of the circle or the radius of the circle. So you can actually enter your commands on your command line, or you can enter the commands from, you know, clicking on all the tools that you have on your toolbar. Now, before we wrap up the session, I want to show you how to, let me just pan this. All right, so I believe that by now you know that you should save your work, save your drawings, save as, and then when you're trying to save as your drawing, you give it the drawing name, and then you click on save. Now, while you are doing your work, it's important that you make up some settings, okay? And I want to show you how to do that. So go to the command line, type on options, okay, and then click on enter, and it brings up this dialog box. You see your different options, files, save, display, open and save, plot and publish, and all of this. But just pay attention to your files, your display, your open and save. So on the open and save, you save as, I'm using AutoCAD 2015, but I want to make sure that anytime it saves, I want it to save as a lower version. So I've set it to 2013. The reason why I've done this is that if I take it to another system, it will open easily, okay? And then you also need to make sure that you select this create backup copy selected with each save. And then also I want you to go back to your display. You can also set the colors of your model space. So you click on colors under display. You can set this color scheme to white if you want to. Click on apply and close. You see it has changed to white. Okay. And then so let's go back. Let's the options display colors, but let's leave it in the black mode for our class. All right, so now under the files, I want you to pay attention to your, just scroll down to your temporary drawing file location, and then note that directory, because you're going to use this now. The next thing I want to show you is how to recover your lost drawing file. So this is going to be users, my you know, the name of your system, of your hard disk drive you're using, your app data, your local, and your temp. So let's pay attention to this. Your users, under your users, you have this name, you have, and you have your temp. Okay, so we close this, and then we go back to close our drawing. Save changes, yes. We close this. So when we come back to this file, if for any reason I deleted this file, you notice that I still have the backup file on my system. Now I can recover my drawing from this backup file by simply right clicking, renaming, and I change this backup to the file extension name DWG, and I click enter. It asks for this, I click OK, and then you can see it has changed back to the drawing file, and you can do just what you want to do. Okay, you can also go back to your users we're doing, and we can look out for our AutoCAD file. You can see all your temporary files for different things you were doing. The temp files are stored here, but you notice that the temp file, actually this was the last thing I did. Okay, 1105, I'm sure that's related to my AutoCAD file. But of course, you know when we're setting up the backup, you should create, and we ask it to save every 10 minutes. So usually after 10 minutes you get, you know, a temporary version of your file, and that's actually a good way. So I want you to try out other options in the with your files.